What you want?
You okay?
Do I look okay?
No. You look awful.
Awful. Looking useless. I wasn't born to this. I didn't deserve this. I used to be a gentleman. Jeremiah Compson. Compson's stead.
Good for you. That's anything to boast about.
They took everything from me.
Who did?
They.
And what did they take?
My whole life. A whole living, a career.
I stole a lot of things, but that's quite a lot to steal.
Look at me here, living in the shit and the mud.
I'm sorry.
My old house. The house my grandfather built. It's all faded and destroyed. Repossessed by the bank.
No, sorry to hear that.
I was supposed to live a different life.
Me too.
If only I could get my old things back. Personal mementos. A watch. Old pistol. My ledger.
Where's this house again?
Thompson's stead, north of Scarlet Meadows. Banks, I can't go near it. I'm living rough over by Harris Field.
Well, if I'm ever out that way, I'll see what I can do.
Time. Time is hell.
Idiot.
I do have a thirst for me.
You okay there, mister?
You need me to move?
Move?
Am I sitting in the wrong place?
Excuse me?
I dim the offense, sir. Please.
I don't get your meaning.
I'm very sorry, sir. You have yourself a fine day, and I apologize for any offense I may have inadvertently caused.
What are you drinking, mister?
Nothing, sir. Nothing at all.
Why are you acting so strange?
I don't mean to. I'm sorry for any offense.
How could you have offended me?
I have. But I had no idea how I offended the last fellas. And they stole my wagon on account of my impudence.
Stole your wagon for back check?
They didn't like my medical practice, I suppose. I was helping folk.
And that wasn't popular?
I was undercutting the competition. Or I was too colored. Or I was irritating in nature, or I was some know-it-all big city slicker here to demean some good old boys of my fine words. The exact variety of my sins was the source of some conjecture, so they undercut me. That was my impression. Still, compared to the gutting, castration, defenestration, and crucifixion they offered me, I felt I got off lightly.
Imaginative bunch.
Yes.
But
no great love of my medical practice. Too free with my services.
Which way they go?
Down the road, that away.
Stay here.
I'm sort of forced to. Please, don't go to any trouble on my account.
Mm-hmm.
Are you looking for that fellow's wagon? I heard him say they was taking it to Macomb's Inn.
Okay, thanks.
Oh!
get you back to the doctor. Get in.
Yeah.
don't you?
Oh, my. Oh, look who it is. I did not count on seeing that wagon again. Nor you, for that matter.
The only people you won't be seeing are the folks that took it.
I take it they aren't the only ignorant bullying clodhop in these parts. But I can live in glorious hope. Now, it wasn't a trouble now, was it?
No, it was a pleasure.
Well, let me give you something for your pleasure. What we got here. How about this? Provide a man a tincture, he'll be well for a day. Teach him to make one, he might be well a while longer.
I'll make sure to try and make this. Thank you.
Thank you. It won't work for anything chronic. You may not need it to. Well, if you see me on my travels and you're in need of something, make sure you come say hello.
Travel safe now. Where's that horse got to?
I seen things. I seen bad things. Saw brother die.
Hey, mister.
We've had enough of you causing trouble.
Morning, Dick.
Morning, mister.
By a dog after it got blown off. So don't you blame me about your goddamn war.
Back again?
Come on now. I ain't asking for much. Hey, mister. Will you give me some money? Thank you. Say, where you from?
Around.
Ain't from around here. Yeah, it was you I'd leave. This town lost its goddamn soul a long time ago. Nothing but nasty, miserable people.
Yeah?
Yeah, ever since them A's moved here. A bunch of no-good white trash. Yeah, they somehow got rich about 50 years ago. They moved here, caused a whole heap of trouble. Yeah, I reckon they was Yankee spies during the war and everything.
That's so.
Yeah, sure.
I'm running out, Rhodes. Get her right here.
I can scarcely
people really enjoy that.
Thanks for your help.
Darn way!
Can I help you?
Like you boys had some trouble.
Yeah, we had some trouble. Bad trouble. What you want?
Oh, I was supposed to meet some business partners here. Arranged a meeting, I believe.
Fellow with a scar and a Mexican?
Yes, sir.
Out by the stables, I think.
Thank you. And, sorry for your troubles, friend.
Up in town, you're helping everybody. And there's troubles everywhere. Bandits attacked my fields and killed.
And have you met my partner, Arthur Morgan?
No.
I met your son, the sheriff.
Okay.
Mr. Gray here was saying how he had problems with a family. A family of degenerates.
Well, nobody likes degenerates.
A hag and her inbred sons. They ruined this county. They killed my uncle, you know.
That ain't right.
Problem is, we can't be seen to get too close.
And?
We've got gold, Yankee. Gold.
I ain't no Yankee, friend. I ain't nothing. My daddy came over on the boat from Scotland.
I'm Scottish.
And the Braithwaites?
Goddamn peasants. I don't know. Mongrels. Slave fuckers. All you gotta do is look at them.
That's gold.
Enough. These are prized horses I'm talking about. Them, they'll get you 5,000.
5,000? For horses?
Easy.
And where do we sell them, these $5,000 horses?
Over in Clemens Cove. Fellow over there will run them out of state and give you 50 cents on the...
Mister, you got yourself a deal.
Just keep us away from this. Publicly, I mean.
My sense is we keep all horse wrestling away from the public.
Go to the stables on the south side of the manor. That's where they keep the thoroughbred.
In front of you.
Why try going straight? Crazy old fool.
If he only knew we just torched his tobacco crop.
That was you?
The old man was cursing the Braithwaites about
burning rich folks' property. Sean's like a pig in shit.
I'm sure. 5,000 for horses. They must be rich.
Yeah. He doesn't know what he's talking about. But we get even a third of that.
How are we gonna play this?
The place is well guarded, so there ain't no point in blasting in there. We'll make them think we're there looking to purchase.
Three armed men?
You'd be armed if you were about to spend 5,000 on horses. We should go in the back way, though. Avoid too many questions.
I'll speak to him, okay?
All right, then.
Can I help you, gentlemen?
Yeah, we're here to see about some horses.
Horses?
Yeah, we had an appointment with Mr. Braithwaite, I believe.
Yeah, I never heard about any of this.
Our partner wanted to make a significant investment in some stables down here. But perhaps we should look elsewhere.
Well, I... Okay, then, but... Head on up to the stables. Someone will come see you.
Easy.
That's it. Nice and easy. No need to rush. Don't want to draw any unnecessary attention. Coming. All right. I think that's the stables just up ahead. Heads down. Play cool. Around the front. Hitch up there. All right, let's hitch up here.
Whoa!
Good boy. Let me do the talking.
Can I help you, boys?
I hope so. Heard you got some horses.
We always got horses.
Fine horses, I mean.
I don't get you, friend.
Yeah, you do. Come on.
Get out of here. You, Sarface, and your greaser buddy.
Whoa!
I don't like officials.
We ain't officials. We're connoisseurs. Looking to do some breedings. Come on now, partner.
Okay, fine. Follow me. These here's mainly the studs available for purchase or for working. If that's what you're interested in. What is your boy's in?
We represent a famous stable and stud farm from Saratoga.
Is that so?
Unofficially.
Of course. This here's Cerberus. Here you go, boy. Cerberus is a real reliable stud. Fathered many a... greaser, huh?
Okay. Bandana's on. We'll need nobody recognizing us.
All right, I'll grab the white one in the middle, you get the other two. Relax, boy. Come on.
Good boy. Easy now.
Marston, you're gonna tether him up to Javier's horse.
Okay.
Javier, you're gonna lead the stallions.
Easy. You're okay.
You all right? Good boy. Marston, you ride point. I'll cover up the back. If there's any problems, we regroup at Clemens Cove.
Okay.
What are you doing?
Let's go, quick!
Get going, you two!
What the hell are you doing?
Stop! Stop! We'll get robbed! I said stop these men! Stop!
More coming this way! Out of the fields! Watch out by that wagon! Wolves!
Clemens Cove's just over there. Come on. Let's get this over with.
Well, it could have gone smoother.
That'll be on my gravestone. Enough! You think they look like they're paying $5,000 for horses?
I guess we'll see.
Come here!
got you.
What you boys want?
You was, heard you pay good prices for horses.
Oh, we'll buy more or less anything, Pop.
That's so?
Sure, Pop. I'm Clay Davies. That's my brother Clive. We're twins.
John, Arthur, Javier.
So what are you, Cuban?
No.
I don't like Cubans.
That's all?
Maybe. Why, what do you care? You a Cuban.
Maybe I like Cubans.
Ooh, you're funny. He's funny. Ain't he funny, Clive? Clive don't talk. We're twins, but I was born first. He came out all yellow and black, but he's okay.
Sure.
Yeah, I know these horses. They ain't yours, but I like you. I can give you 650 for
them. I was told we could get to $5,000 for them.
And I was told the moon was made of ladies' tears. Only it ain't true. Not one little bit.
But...
I like you boys, but I ain't got more than 700 on me. You want it, or you want to ride them fellers into town, and maybe someone there will hang you.
We're gonna need more than that.
I ain't got no more money, Pop. Here, take it or leave it. Uh-huh.
All right.
You goddamn fool, Marston.
Ain't no one around here got $5,000, boys, but nice meeting you. See you boys again, I hope. Come on. Yeah. Close it.
Believed a yarn spun us by one of that Gray family. And maybe he was gonna be wonderfully rich. At the end of it, we felt like prize idiots.